Run, just kind of slow it down a little bit, give you guys an introduction to the new abilities and some of the weapons in the game. So we're going to do this in a little bit of a hacky way. Perry's going to sit here. He's going to spawn a couple enemies in. Mm-hmm. We're doing this kind of showing you a little peek behind the curtain. So, you know.
Yeah, you can't typically spawn in your own enemies when you're playing the game.
No.
We're just going to have some fun
this
breaking the game a little
fun.
Bit. Just do it.
So we want to do, what do we want to do? Ground slam? Can I showcase that?
Let me hit them back first.
Okay.
But yeah, we can do a ground slam, the easiest and probably the best AoE sort of attack. You see they go flying. Does a lot of damage to mobs.
Yes, it's kind of a crowd control power. And the higher up you are, the more damage you do.
Then we can do the vortex, which is my favorite, which is kind of sucks them into this thing here, and then they go flying in the air. And you can shoot them, and then they'll also go flying. Then another good one, we got Shatter. That will shatter them to pieces.
Nice. Sure.
It's my favorite. Yeah, that's a good one. And then we can do, show you another good defensive one. Go up against somebody with a rocket, toss up a barrier, and then it's the barrier and you're good
total
to go.
Deflection.
And then when you upgrade that, it kind of turns into an offensive weapon. So there's a lot of upgrades in this game, right, Tim? Like you can upgrade each ability, each weapon yourself.
Yeah, so so when you play through Rage 2, if you notice that the enemies will drop these little blue crystals, that's Feltripe. So you collect the Feltripe, and you can spend that on upgrading your abilities like cooldown, effective range, damage. And also all the weapons and items are upgradable. So there is really a deep path to your upgrade tree in the game.
Awesome.
And we just saw one of your favorite upgrades to the wingstick.
Yes, the grinding wingstick.
The grinding, which
so,
is just
oh, that was
devastating.
The multiple strike.
Yeah, that's
yes.
good.
So the wingstick, again, you can straight forward or you can lock on. You can grind enemies, which I love. And then you can do the multiple targets and explosive. Very cool. Oh. You know, one of the things that we really tried to work into the combat, and it's the cornerstone of the abilities, is getting you, the player, into the action. You know, the main list of abilities, as you can see, move you close into the fight. And that's very kind of id Software style, getting you into the action, that push forward combat that we love so much.
But what's fun is that being able to do that push forward combat in the open world allows you to go up to a cliff and basically shove an enemy right off of it too. Right?
Yes, which is so much fun.
Super satisfying.
So those are some of the core abilities. Do we want to showcase some of the new toys, the weapons?
Yeah, sure. So the AR is pretty versatile, self-explanatory. The shotgun, you know, obviously has a nice hip fire, classic shotgun, but this one also, if you aim down the sights, does kind of an energy wave type thing that sends them flying, breaks through their armor. Rocket launcher, really cool, you know. Nice explosions, but the cool thing about that is if you do some combos with it, so we can throw a vortex grenade down, and then it'll track while they're in the air. You can blow them up that way and sort of play with your enemies like that. Then we have the one that's almost too fun to use, hard to put away sometimes, is the grav dart launcher. Fill them up with these gravity pellets, and then you can send them in the air.
I love that gun so
much. Are they going to be okay?
You know, we'll find out.
Okay.
Very much not.
Just was curious. I didn't know.
And going back to with the rocket launcher, you fill them up with some pellets again, then send them in the air. And then hit him with a rocket if it'll target him. So they went too high. That's how powerful it is. We'll do one more. Let's try single.
So the more you tag them, basically, the higher up they go.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh.
It's just overkill the game.
Yeah.
Do you have the Firestorm revolver?
Yeah. So that one is also pretty good. So just by itself, we can just show you what it does. So you hit him with these like explosive incendiary pellets, snap your fingers.
The Thanos snap.
And
so you
then
really
they,
can kill enemies in a snap, I guess.
It's yeah. a snap.
And the fun thing to do as well is if you combo the abilities and the weapons. So if we get another enemy in here, dumb goon, if we do something like put a vortex grenade down, then hit him with a few pellets, then send him up, and then snap.
Oh, oh. Little char skeleton.
Like a, yeah. Like a hard thud.
I know. He's looking all right.
Oh.
So that's the fun thing. It's kind of figuring out the best combos with all the weapons and just seeing what you can do and really playing with your food, so to speak.
Yeah. Oh, some God. Folks from chat want to know what's the game engine we're using, and it's actually the Avalanche engine, correct?
Yes. Yeah. This is the Avalanche Apex engine.
Yep.
You know, they've been working on this technology for a while. It's powered some of their other games, and it really allows us to make a true open world game with no level loads between the first person action areas and your open world exploration.
Just go to all the biomes you want to, and yep. You know, no load.
It's all seamless, and it looks so pretty.
Yep.
Yes. You know, and as you can see, like I said, we really wanted the game to look different from the original game, and this is a great location to showcase that. We have some unique vegetation. You know, we have the mist and the blue sky, and it has a raised look, but it's not, you know, 50 Shades of Brown.
Yep.
And a really nice day and night cycle, too. So as you're driving through the wasteland, you're going to, you know, encounter the different biomes with, like, nighttime and, you know, seeing.
I love driving through the world at night, especially really when you drive up to a place like Wellspring where it's just decked out in the neon signs, and it's just really, really pretty.
Yeah.
Or at sunset. And everything just goes that beautiful sunset shade of pink and orange, and really nice.
Yes, sunset's definitely my favorite time as well.
So I guess now that we kind of gave them a taste of the weapons and abilities, do we want to jump into kind of an outpost takedown?
Yeah.
So let's put it all together, basically, and visit an outpost and see if we can take down some bad guys.
So we'll go up here to Rash River, which it's pretty cool, pretty nice playground.
How are you going to get there?
We want to talk about the diversity in vehicles, Tim?
So one of the things that we're really proud of in Rage 2 is, you know, of course we have the Phoenix, which is really cool. But as you see Perry go through our garage, you can see all the vehicles that you can spawn in. Now, the trick is you have to steal these vehicles and return them to one of the cities to unlock them in your garage. Mm-hmm. And we have tanks. We have monster trucks, which I love. We even have a hover boat. And I think are you going to take the gyrocopter, our flying vehicle? Is that what you're going to use? Or
no, let's take the monster truck.
Monster truck?
Want to do monster truck?
Yes. Monster truck.
Okay.
We should know. I know we talked about this yesterday, but the Phoenix is your vehicle, and it's voiced by Linda Carter.
Oh, yes. Yeah, yeah. We had the privilege of working with Miss Wonder Woman herself, and she gave a lot of personality and flair to the Phoenix.
Yeah.
It makes you form a relationship with your vehicle that I didn't think I'd ever have.
Not since Knight Rider.
I mean, now my car in real life has a name. It's not Linda, though.
What is it?
It's Jonathan.
Okay.
My car's name is Jonathan.
That's cool.
Convoy.
I named him after Jonathan Goodwin.
Oh.
Not equipped to hit that.
So you'll be driving around, and these convoys will come by, and if you want to engage with them, you can.
Yeah, he was very smart to sidestep that convoy.
Well, that would be embarrassing if you got taken down.
I did watch somebody try and take on a convoy with the monster truck earlier today at the demo stations,
awesome.
And I was like, that's, I mean, good luck. not as heavily weaponized as your Phoenix is, for sure.
Yeah.
So as you saw when Perry drove by that little gang of bandits there, so in the whole world, all those encounters are dynamic. So you may run across a roadblock, you may run across a bandit tribe, or like a group of bandits, mutant tribe, or a group of bandits that will shoot at you. So you have to always be careful.
Racers. There are a bunch of people who want to try and challenge you to races while you're out in the world.
Yes.
And the way that system works is really interesting, too.
Yeah, you just honk at them, and a race starts, and you can compete. And if you win the race, you win that vehicle.
But all of the tracks are dynamically created based on where you are in the world.
Yes.
So you can start a race anywhere, and it just creates the track instantly. That's really cool.
So we're over in the River Hog area. Was this? The River Hog area. And you can tell that these bandits will fight differently than the Immortal Shrouded or the Goon Squad.
Oh. Never gets old. So hard to put away.
What would you say the River Hog style is?
They just like the bum rush, and they're heavily armored.
Except when they're not, and they're like mostly naked.
Yeah, they have really tough skin.
But they do have those big guys with the shields, yeah. And something that we're gonna see in just a minute here, I think. So I'm not gonna spoil it.
Perry is so good at playing. I joke that if you buy the special edition, it comes with a Perry in the box.
Yeah, we should note that like there are different difficulty settings well. Like you can really make this a challenge. Yeah. But he's just exceptionally good at this game. This is not what it looks like.
Makes me feel bad about myself.
Yeah.
Which is fun for me.
Now we got the junk mech.
Oh god.
Uh-oh.
There it is.
There it is. The redneck mech.
Oh.
Now with him, best thing to do is to avoid most of the fire. But he's kind of got these weak spots that you have to hit.
So there is some strategy to it.
Yeah, it's a lot of dodging.
I mean, he does look like something that a man with too much time and access to a junkyard might make.
With a twisted sense of, yes. So he's using the pulse cannon now, which you have to regulate the rate of fire based on the temperature. So it's kind of this balance act. By keeping it right on the edge of overheating, you actually get the most damage.
Do you have a favorite weapon?
Yeah, I mean, well, the grab gun is awesome.
Yeah.
But I still love the wing stick. I'm an old school wing stick, as you can tell by my wing stick skills in real life.
In real life, you've worked to become a wing stick master.
Yes.
So that's impressive.
Whoa.
What about you, Jason? Do you have a favorite weapon?
I don't know. Sometimes I feel like just the shotgun is just so... Like that satisfying power of a shotgun. You can't
I love
that.
The alt fire for the shotgun. It's great.
Yeah, it's really impressive.
I think mine's the Firestorm Revolver though, and only because I love the drama of the snap.
Yeah.
It's very good.
And that's the Firestorm Revolver is actually one of the more difficult weapons to find because it's in an arc that is in contested territory between the Immortal Shrouded and the Riverhawks. So you got to take out two bandits. Squads before you can even get into that arc.
Which is not easy,
definitely.
So for them, it's got to just be a territory squabble thing because neither of them can open the arc. They just want it because the other one wants it.
Exactly, yes.
All right.
They know it's valuable.
Sure.
Someone wanted to know if this is exclusive for PC on the Bethesda launcher. It's also on Steam.
Yeah, it is on Steam.
Yep. It's on Steam, so Perry here just unlocked an arc chest. Arc chests are like full-size arcs, and they contain vehicle upgrades, weapon upgrades, nanotroid upgrades.
Okay.
So definitely search around all the areas and look for those arc chests.
And I think you can even buy arc chest maps at certain vendors in towns and just kind of around the world.
Yes. Yeah. If you're not good at finding them, you can buy the map.
I mean, some of us need a little help.
So can you talk a little bit about what you're doing right now?
I love that upgrade.
Because that wasn't just a sprint.
Right, that's rush. So that's really good if you want to get to point A to point B really fast or get through a bunch of enemies and make sure they don't see you because you kind of go invisible. So there's a sprint and then there's that. So you kind of get this cloaking ability on and kind of hit
like
double
he's driving.
Time.
It does kind of look like he's driving a little invisible car.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So we're going to go off the road a little bit.
Let's try the Abaddon Sanctum.
Yeah.
We're going to try a different vehicle out?
That's a good idea. Let's do...
Let's see.
One of the tanks, maybe?
We can do the tank.
The Goon tank is my favorite. I like it more than the Immortal Shrouded tank. Some of the crazy stuff that they welded on.
I really like their like base level vehicle with all the mannequins strapped to the top of it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because why not?
Because why not?
So are we heading to that arc, or are we heading to that outpost?
The Abaddon Sanctum.
Oh, yes. Yeah, yeah. Yes.
I'm going to fight some mutants.
I don't know if this is the best place to take this.
Do you like how he power slid in the tank?
Yeah, it was skillful.
So it's going to always show you on the road the best way to get there.
Too thin.
Yeah.
Even if it's through some
brush. Should have went with the bike. Here's where Rush comes in handy.
This area is so beautiful.
Uh-oh.
Where there it goes. This way. Here we go.
Guess you want to talk a little bit about the Abaddons and...
Yeah, so the Abaddon mutants have actually evolved from your kind of basic mutant in the original Rage. So they're a little smarter. We actually have some lore, some fiction around, you know, their genesis and, you know, that they worship Nicholas Rain as the death god. And this is really a great example of, you know, seamlessly moving out from driving tank in the wasteland into a very kind of id Software style, kind of, for lack of a better word, corridor shooter.
It definitely has like those Doom vibes.
Yes, yes.
Yesterday, somebody asked if there were still going to be like underground areas of the game, and yes, there are.
Right here. And his overdrive. There he goes. So Perry just went in overdrive. The faster you take out your enemies. And the quicker that you pick up the Feltrag, that will recharge and your overdrive meter. And once that's full, you go into overdrive, which makes you more powerful, makes you move faster, gives you some health, and it makes your weapons more powerful.
Oh no. Let's make this fun. We use the...
You know, one of the things that I encourage people to do is, like Perry is doing, use your abilities in combination together with your weapons and your items. That's really where the game shines, and that's when you can do amazing things like he's doing right now.
Nice.
Just get out of my way for a second.
What is that big mutant?
Yes, that's one of our big super mutants. He's got a big Gatling gun. And, you know, he's always surrounded by other mutants that will rush you. So he'll lay down some heavy fire.
He has some heavy duty. Like, is he launching a bunch of grenades at you, or what was?
Well,
you know,
it's like a Gatling gun. It's powered machine gun. And then of course, so he has a weapon core mod. The weapon core mods, along with the Feltrite, are critical to upgrading, of course, your weapons.
You able to use that weapon core mod, or are you fully upgraded?
And what's also shotgun? Interesting is that. Remember how I talked about the three characters that you work with?
I think Marty
so. Each
out.
Of those characters, when you complete activities in the world, like you take out a mutant nest or a convoy, you will help one of those three characters, and through that help, you'll upgrade their progression tree.
And this particular mission that he's on right now is actually a mission to find a ranger that went missing in the wasteland, and. I don't think Ranger Baker made it, because I'm pretty sure that's his torso.
Oh, but you found intel over him.
Yeah, we found something.
So there's a little bit
and
left.
I think it's Baker's guts.
Well, it took guts to go down the tunnel, I guess. Right?
Yeah, so
and the tunnel took his guts.
So as you can see, this was like a bossier activity.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks, Laugh Track.
Thanks for the Laugh Track.
And, you know, once completing that activity, you earn points for Kavassir, and you saw where it says +3 project points.
Yep.
Well, you can take those project points, and you can go into your projects tab, and then you can upgrade specific upgrades or abilities based on
actually,
which character.
That's something that we didn't really get a chance to talk about yesterday. Perry, can we look through a couple of those upgrades really quick just to see between, you know, your project upgrades, mm-hmm. your weapon upgrades, your nanotrite upgrades. Like, there are a lot of different options.
Yeah, and paths to go through.
So yeah, so this is a tree, and as you can see, there's four tiers, and then once you unlock projects on the preceding tier, it allows you access to the next one. So if you're into, you want more items to carry, or you want to, you know, reload faster, you can find kind of a tree that you can move down and you can upgrade.
Obviously, Lusum's tree is the one with all the wing stick upgrades.
Mm-hmm. Right. Definitely.
Man, there's all kinds, and it completely changes the game the more you get. Just like the wing stick thing, it's really cool to be able to hit three or four enemies with one or explode a whole group just with one. So it's fun to go hunting around for the pieces that you need to upgrade these things.
Very cool.
So I think we have time to hit like one more, hit an arc. We've talked a little bit about that early on, but we haven't really shown it.
You just want to take the gyrocopter over there, maybe?
We're not that far. This is the closest arc right here. We'll just go to that one. We can maybe take a different vehicle, though.
Is it the Phoenix?
What should we take? These are pretty cool.
Your pick. You can choose Barry.
Let's just do the Devastator.
Okay.
It's the Immortal Shrouded, one of their vehicles. Pretty cool looking.
We did talk about this a little bit yesterday when we were talking about some of the different factions. Obviously, the River Hogs are a little bit more ramshackle, a lot of like junk equipment, basically, stuff that they've kind of scrapped together. The Goon Hogs are just wild and crazy guys. They are
Immortal Shrouded base, and you don't have the upgrades, you may want to think twice about taking them out.
Maybe wait a little bit, mark it, put a pin in it, and come back later.
Yeah. So as you can see, there's an arc here, which is kind of, there's a battle between some authority mutants. So what you need to do is you need to clear out all the enemies before you can unlock that arc.
Including that guy.
Including the Cyber Crusher.
Because he's a lot bigger than the rest of them. They seemed, you know, not too difficult, but...
Yes, a good rule of thumb is whenever you see a health meter, you know it's a tough boss battle.
Yeah.
Also, good rule of thumb with this game, whenever you see something glowing and blue, maybe aim for that.
Yeah, look for the weak points.
Aim for that.
They often glow.
That's a good tip.
I mean, that's kind of one of the number one rules of games, always aim for the glowing weak points.
That and shoot the red barrels.
Shoot the red barrels.
Always shoot the red barrels.
Use your focus to blow them up with your mind.
Yes,
right. That's true too.
Let's do that.
Oh, close.
A few more. Don't have any rockets left. That's not good. It's never good when you run out of rockets. But hopefully, I'm good.
Dash.
I'm good.
Get a dash.
All right, let's get this one done. There's one side.
All right, one more side left.
Close. Keeps hurting me with that laser.
Almost got him.
So if he had his overdrive meter is almost full, but if that was full, and as soon as Cyber Crusher goes into the weak state, hit overdrive, you know, you usually almost take out both of those and knock him off pretty quick.
Nice.
There we go.
All right.
Now almost.
It's just raw damage.
Now we got his brain out. Thought he was gonna jump.
Got him.
Nice.
I will say, though, for being such a big guy, he's very agile.
Yeah.
And he can jump real far.
That's some authority technology there.
Nicely done.
Kind of feel bad for him, though.
So once you clear out the area, you can actually open up the arc using focus.
Yes.
You can probably grab it and go to the UMS nearby and then show off.
I don't know that we want to spoil what exactly is in all of the arcs, though. So maybe we just leave it?
Got a little bit of time.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll grab it.
Yeah, okay. It's up to you.
Show off the hyper cannon.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Come on. There we go.
There he goes. So yeah, as Tim mentioned, in all of these arcs, you're going to find different weapons and abilities. So as you play the game, your arsenal becomes bigger and bigger. And, you know, learning how to master the combos of putting these things together is where the fun really happens in the Wasteland.
And every time you get something from one of these arcs, you go to one of these kind of tutorial areas where it'll teach you exactly how to use it and fun tricks for it. Like with the hyper cannon, where it just plows through multiple people.
Exactly, all in one shot.
So, funny story. We were lucky enough to have our faces scanned to be characters in the game.
Yep.
And our senior producer that works on the project with me at Bethesda, he had his head scanned, and they've actually used him for all these guys here. So there's like tearing them apart and all the
so every time
rooms.
You're mad at him, you just went
just
into
just
a
just
just go into a tutorial.
So that means
why me?
When people play the game, they actually should be looking for you, right?
I have a small cameo,
yes,
my
do.
Face.
A small but glorious cameo.
It is memorable. It is very memorable.
If you find him, you know what? If you find Tim in the Wasteland, hit up the Rage Twitter account with
the
screen of him, because he is
special.
Really something special.
You guys are bad.
Hey, you had to have signed off on it, so.
So I guess we can show it off in action a little bit. There's like a mutant nest over here. Probably can show off the hyper cannon.
Yeah, it's pretty devastating.
It's actually one of the only like long range weapons in the game.
Yeah, yeah. So we have no classic sniper rifle. And because we really want to encourage you, like I said before, to get you into the action, because that's where it's the most fun. But of course, it would not be an id Software game without some type of railgun-like weapon.
Sure.
And this one is definitely a ton of fun. But as you saw, you have to take out a Cyber Crusher in order to get it.
Someone said there's no way he's playing with the controller. No, he really is.
No, he really is.
He's that good.
He's that good.
It's an elite controller.
We
gotta
can
caveat with that.
Yes.
Yeah, if it was me, it wouldn't look so, so good. But yeah, Harry's able to play super fast, and it's incredible.
It's a lot of practice.
He's far better than us on the team.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go back to the favor, or one of these.
I do love the way the Abaddon mutants move and how they interact with their surroundings. Like that one that just jumped and crawled along the wall and then jumped out
at like,
you.
Yeah, like fast spiders that are chasing after you.
Well, now I hate them. Thank you.
And now his overdrive is full too.
Messed up.
Here we go.
Oh, wow.
Oh, the poor little mutants.
The grav dart launcher does have a lot of super useful applications, though. Whether you're launching, you know, explosive barrels into crowds of enemies, or tossing them into the sky, or tossing them into each other.
Yeah.
Like, there are a lot of incredibly mean things that you can do with that gun.
Yeah, how fast he had overdrive again?
Yeah.
Because he has a 10x multiplier. So the faster you take down your enemies, and the faster you pick up that felt drive, the faster that will charge. And
it's
you
like
can
a
keep
loop.
That loop
yeah.
going, yeah. And he got an upgrade.
Cool. Well, yeah, I think we showed a lot of the game. I don't know if we want to spoil anything else. so we'll probably
right now is kind of just slow it down a little bit.
Yep.
show you the kind of the core abilities, some of the upgrades. But just caveating, we're doing this in a little bit of a hacky way, kind of giving you a peek behind the curtains. So Perry's going to spawn a couple enemies, show off some of these abilities, and we'll just kind of give you a peek of what they do. And then we'll run out to an outpost and kind of put it all together.
Really? Yeah. Starting with yeah. weapons
yeah,
or what, abilities?
So we can just do kind of the simple, we'll do the simple abilities first just to sort of show them off just in this form. So I'll spawn this guy in, just get his attention.
Yeah, and just then, to be clear, you can't usually spawn enemies in the game.
No,
yeah,
you're
hanging
a little
disappear.
Bit. So the purposes of
have
this.
Some fun, so.
So obviously we have stuff like the slam that will just, you know, completely obliterate him.
It's like fruit punch just popped out of him.
And as Tim
he's
mentioned, like the
paste.
The higher you are, the more damage you do.
Yeah, so I'll go up here and do something like this, bring him a little higher, wake him up a little bit. Hey, I'm over here. Get a little higher, and the higher you go, like Carlos said, the more damage you do. So if there's more enemies, you want to go higher. That way you can get more of them. And then, let's see, I can show off the one that's very fun to use that you can split them apart with is Shatter. That'll also send them over the cliff. And then what else do we have we want to show? The I guess we'll do Vortex.
Yeah,
Vortex
yeah,
is
Vortex.
Cool because that'll kind of bring them up like that. You can do all kinds of stuff with them there. You shoot him, it'll give him a little boost and also send him over the cliff.
What is your deal with
and
this
another
sending
ability
people over
that
cliffs?
Comes in handy
<It's addictive. laughs>
is the dash as well. So let's say you have somebody shooting an RPG at you. You can get out of the way of it and just kind of watch it go by. Or another good example of an ability is the barrier that'll protect you from a lot of stuff.
Nice.
And then you can hover over it like that and take them out that way.
Yes, yeah, so you basically can double jump and hover in the
yeah,
air, right?
Yeah, you just
right.
float it.
Yeah, so if you double jump
yeah.
and then ADS, aim down your sight, then you hover. So that's another ability. So there's all kinds of stuff. So
nice.
That's sort of them one by one, right? Mm-hmm. So we want to see some, I guess, combos at this point?
Yes,
yeah.
sir.
Yeah.
So going higher, obviously I can go up on things like this, but if you throw the vortex grenade down, then do a double jump, then get up, you go even higher. And do stuff like that. So if we want to spawn in a couple enemies, wake them up a bit, you can oh, hey, there's a vendor here. Good timing. Throw this down to stop, and then throw that, and then get over it, and take them out that way.
Vortex Shatter. Can you try that one out?
Huh?
Vortex Shatter.
Vortex Shatter. That's a good one. Wait for my vortex to come back. There it is. So that's fun. And then what are the other combos we like to show? All kinds of stuff.
You can do the slide dash shatter.
Yep.
That's a good one. So
I fully
let's get
expect
in.
All the people who are getting ready to play the game to be able to do all of these
we
when
see
it's
this.
Your turn to hop
yeah.
in. And if I
so
don't
do
see that, I'll be so disappointed.
And then,
I see
on.
You. I'm looking
his
right
legs.
At you.
That was only the lower half of his body. The top half just got disintegrated. So there's all kinds of stuff you can do with combos, and you get creative. Should we maybe show some of the weapons?
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
So we can go one by one here, I guess, with this. So the AR is pretty self-explanatory. That's pretty versatile. It's fun to use. Then we have the shotgun, which, you know, we're all familiar with shotguns, but when you ADS, well, just threw them off the cliff. But when you ADS, it kind of gives you this this different alternate fire mode that's sort of like an air cannon that sends them off cliffs as well. I love throwing things off cliffs in this game. It's my favorite thing to do.
This is funny. The vendor thinks you want to shop.
Yeah.
This is cracking me up.
and then
shop?
We have rocket launcher, of course. Always fun to use. You can do some really great combos with that.
The vortex rocket launcher.
Yeah, well, actually, we'll do. Why don't we combine the vortex with the grav dart launcher and the rocket launcher? So, another good one to do is get somebody in here, and then if you fill them up with these gravity pelts, then you hit them with a vortex, then you send them in the air.
Oh!
That split him up. I think he hit
on,
something on the way.
Do it again. Do it again.
We're going to do it again because this gets really cool. So we'll skip the vortex this time. Just go straight to the gravity dart. Send him in the air. Why is he's blowing up immediately. I don't know what he's hitting.
You're just too powerful.
Hey, can you
I don't know
tree.
What's going on.
There,
there he goes.
And if you get him high enough, you can track him. We're going to get one. Let me do another one. Let's send him straight up. This gun is too fun to use.
There you go.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Nice.
Just extreme overkill, but that's kind of what this game is all about.
Can you hit him with the wing stick? Can you hit him with a wing stick in the air?
Yeah, yep. We can do that.
All right. We'll see how your wing stick skill is.
So we'll bring in, let's
yeah, so
do
Tim,
a shroud
at
this
for all
time.
The Rage 1 fans, the wing stick is back. Do you want to talk about kind of the upgrades? And
yeah, so, you know, the wing stick is a signature weapon from the original. And, you know, one of the things you can do...
He's hitting the tree. That's
he's hitting
done.
The tree branch. You know, it has a full upgrade path, just like your weapons and your abilities. So we have, you know, lock-on, we have explodable, we have multiple targets. We have the grind, which is my favorite, which is stuck into somebody in the...
I missed.
You...
Come back.
Oh, no! All right.
I missed.
All right, the third time's a charm. And then my favorite is when it gets stuck in people, grinds them up, and then explodes.
Which is... Horrifying, which, Tim. Horrifying.
Whose idea was that?
I want to say it's Tim's.
No, it wasn't mine.
I want to say it's Tim's because it's awful. It's so gory.
There we go.
I love it so much.
Good job, Perry.
This whole game is so... We were talking about it yesterday. It's so brutal in the most wonderful way.
Yes, we really wanted to... it's so over the top in some of the combat,
and it's
kind of fun, but it's all in context. But it is it's an enjoyable orchestra of destruction.
Yeah.
Yes.
I was messing around with the game the other day, trying to grab gifts from it, and I was slowing down between screens, and there was one where a person's brain just kind of pops out of their head. That was fun. Yeah. I just froze on that screen for a second. I was like, oh. That's a realistic-looking brain.
That's funny.
So the wing stick also has a couple things you can do with it. Yep. Well, actually, you can hit those back to him as well.
Yeah, someone just asked if you were actually like hitting the grenade back. So
yes,
you are.
You can just hit him right back to him and blow him up, just like a lot of other things in the
game.
I think
that's...
They're reacting to what you're using, where you are, and how they're working together. It's very complex. It's more than just brains flying out. So this is a firestorm pistol.
You hit enemies
with the kind of a charge round, and then you snap it to make them explode.
And then
he just turned into
bones.
A charred skeleton.
Yep, just bones.
Again, Tim.
That's fun. It is fun.
All in the name of fun.
What's tough is the arc where this pistol is located is guarded by the River Hogs. And that redneck mech. So to get this weapon, you got to go through a fight, which is pretty cool. Yeah,
I think that stuff makes it fun, the fight and the hunt.
Yeah, so in Overdrive, you can see that just taking these enemies down is so much easier and more satisfying because you're so much more powerful floating in the air.
So do we want to kind of put it all together and go see it live in action?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so a lot of times the enemies will hide out at different outposts, and you basically can go there and clear them out. So now that we've seen all of the weapons and abilities kind of put together, we'll take the Icarus and just go over to one of them.
Oh. That was awesome.
Hey,
double speed, and then you go sort of invisible. But you can also combine that as well, so when you see enemies end of a lane, and then you want to pop it after it recharges here, you can then hit them with the shatter. And then that's for, oh, there's more people. I gotta stay out of the street.
You're playing in the street, man.
Stop.
I gotta stay over here
in the street.
I gotta stay in the yard. I should have learned that when I was a kid.
Even the pros sometimes get crushed by cars.
So where
I just
was I
love
going?
That upgrade. It's perfect for getting in combat. It's perfect for getting out of combat.
What did you do?
Did your mother teach you not to play in the street?
Let me get another one in and fly back to where we're going. This time, let's stay above the vehicles.
And we'll go through here
a little
bit. It was funny.
Go to, I guess, the where were we going? We were going to that...
Drop Dead Canyon?
Yeah, that's it. Drop Dead. And I think it's this way. It's where we were. So we'll go back that way. Out of the jungle, which is one of the coolest places to fight.
Yeah. Things ain't final in space. Go in prepared, Walker. It has a new host, though, and she's very... odd.
She is an interesting
character.
She's
very odd.
Yes. We had a lot of fun when we created these characters.
Part of me wants to say, you know what, I would like to be Desdemonia when I grow up. And then I see her drinking blood, and I'm like, less so. Less so.
Maybe not for you.
Maybe not quite.
So Perry found our outpost.
Yes. And made my way back there after playing in the street.
Perry, no. Just trying to pee. Come on.
So the faster that you take down your enemies, you can see Perry's overdrive meter there. He's got 6x. The faster you take your enemies down, especially when you're in overdrive, the faster overdrive meter will charge, and it gets you into this fast loop cycle, which kind of gets you into the action. Because this is a big world, as you can see, but everything we do with the weapons and the abilities gets you into the action, up close and personal. It's very very id Software style combat.
I do love the Grav Dart Launcher. It's just such a...
It's very satisfying.
As I mentioned earlier, I'm a big utility player, and there are so many uses for that. You can attach it to an explosive barrel and send that into a crowd of people. You can attach people to, you know, windmills like we saw in the Wasteland superhero trailer. Like,
it's so true.
There are so many weird things that you can do with that gun that just make this game so fun.
So Perry's using the pulse cannon right now, and this thing just will tear through your enemies, but you have to meter it for the heat. So you can see that bar right there. So there's kind of a sweet spot between overheating it and then getting the maximum damage out of it. So you have to kind of pay attention. You can't just tear through your enemies.
And there's definitely bigger enemy types, like that guy right there.
Which I mean, he's just
gone.
Bones now, though, so.
Yeah, the Goon Squad is totally reckless.
Look at that 10x max. So Perry has maxed out his boost on the overdrive. That's how good he is. And of course, one of the arc chests, very important. And he'll probably get, like, auto parts, which is cool.
See this place. Goddamn Ranger Jersey would have treaded with caution here.
Yeah, Jersey died, so you gotta be better than him. Make sure you got the gear and the skills you need before going in.
Yeah, I gotta get me a boat. Bitches love boats.
Back! beginning.